In recent years, there has been an increase in incidence of infectious syphilis in South Australia. There are currently two outbreaks, the first in urban men who have sex with men, and the second in Indigenous Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander population, heterosexual population. There is also concern that there could be bridging, basically, of these two populations and overlap, but there are other drivers, basically, involved in it. The outbreak amongst our Aboriginal and Torres Strait Islander population actually started in 2011 in north of Queensland. Unfortunately, the lack of response has resulted in its spread over the north of Australia. Since 2016, we have had cases here in South Australia. We have congenital syphilis now. This is a real concern for a developed country like Australia. It should not be happening and is a national disgrace.
We know that our population are very mobile, and we know that people from remote areas often travel to the city. Very real chance that there could be some crossover between men who have sex with men and people who live in remote and go back to communities without knowing they have either syphilis and or HIV. Now that would be disaster for our population if HIV goes back to communities unknowingly and people transmit unknowingly to others in remote communities.
There are several stages of syphilis. However, it can go unnoticed and can mimic many different conditions. Syphilis is highly infectious. 70 to 100% of neonates born to mothers with infectious syphilis will be affected. And of that, 40% of them will actually die and will have increasing morbidity associated with it in the form of congenital syphilis. We must be very, very wary. We must test and we must make sure that there are no further cases of congenital syphilis.
Predominantly, and for over 20 years now, there have been high rates of sexually transmissible infections in many remote communities across the north of Australia. And during that whole period, we've had very low rates of HIV infection. Now, the syphilis outbreak brings a whole lot of new risks because the chancre, when it first appears, if HIV comes into contact, greatly enhances HIV transmission. So it's really kind of important that GPs have that in the forefront of their mind when testing for STIs, not only to test for syphilis, but for other STIs, including HIV.
People who are pregnant can acquire syphilis in pregnancy, and if it's left untreated, it can have serious consequences. So congenital syphilis can cause not only stillbirth and premature labour, it can cause death of the neonate and severe congenital abnormalities. Syphilis screening has always been offered at the first antenatal visit. New guidance from SA Health recommends that you screen pregnant people 5 times in pregnancy. So at the first visit, but also at 28 and 36 weeks at delivery and 6 weeks postpartum. And this is to prevent congenital syphilis from occurring. Like many STIs, syphilis is often asymptomatic, and a lot of people may not know that they have it. Aboriginal people from the outbreak areas and also metropolitan areas should be offered syphilis screening. People who identify as men who have sex with men should also be offered testing at least once a year, as should their female partners. And if they're HIV positive or taking PrEP, they should be having syphilis screening every 3 months. People who have also tested positive for another sexually transmitted infection should be offered syphilis serology, and it should be offered as part of a routine sexual health check, particularly in people aged between 16 and 40. You could also offer it as part of any other adult health check. Say we're taking a bunch of blood for other tests, why don't we check you for this? Syphilis serology can be complex to interpret. If there's any uncertainty, then you should contact a specialist such as a sexual health physician for further advice. So it's very important to make sure that anyone who has a positive syphilis result has their partners notified and treated as well. The treatment generally consists of an injection of penicillin, and the number of injections depends on the length of infection and whether or not a person is pregnant. You should seek specialist advice if you're uncertain as to the length of infection, and also if you're treating someone who's pregnant or has a suspected penicillin allergy.
At least 50% of cases of syphilis actually go unnoticed and they are asymptomatic. So not only is it important to actually have a high index of suspicion when you are faced with clinical signs, but also you must consider being proactive in testing at-risk groups. Syphilis is returning, it's increasing in its incidence, and it is moving very, very quickly. We need to be ready and be aware. My key message would be: think syphilis, could it be syphilis, and test.